Hey guys, welcome to Earthit. So today we're gonna make this cute little multi-purpose art decor with materials that's gonna be easily available in our home. Let's begin. So if we wanna make a planter, we'll take a base with holes. If not, let's take a flat based mold. We're gonna use fabric molded because it's easy to work with, and let's roll them. And these are the two components that's gonna be inside that bag. Let's roll them to find a nice dough instead of kneading them. In order to form a nice and sturdy base, we're going to wrap this clay around the mold that we have taken and let's smoothen it with water. So it's okay if we have undulations, and if it's okay if you have bumps, they'll all be covered in the painting, or we can also use water to smoothen them out really well. Make sure to cover all the parts, or it's completely depending upon our design where we want to and where we don't want to. If you have smoothened it out and if there's water left in the surface of the clay, do not touch it with bare hands, as it will get your fingerprints. Now, in order to make the teddy bear, we're gonna take an equally sized dough or clay, and we're just going to segregate it into five different parts. One for head, two for its legs, and two for its hands by pinching and separating it from them. We're not gonna remove it off. We're just going to keep this as a base structure, and we're just gonna extend those parts out of the body. This way, it'll be easy for us in the later stage. It won't remove off, it won't wear off from the main mold, and it's going to be easy for us to fix. Start creating creases or the shapes and start adding details once you have the size and proportion of whatever structure we want to create. You can start smoothening it using water even in this stage, or start using any other toolkit depending upon the type of structure that you want to create, or depending upon the type of creature or animal or any feature that you want to create in here. So this is the mold. I'm just checking if the height is like exactly matching up with my existing mold, and once it's done and once it's confirmed, I'm going to start adding details again to it. So it's always important for us to cross check with the base mold if the proportions and stuffs are correct. And for the details, I'm just pinching here to add its ears and a tiny bump to add its nose for the bear. And do it clearly until you find, or like until you're satisfied with the structure that you get. Again, use water, or you can use any tools to get the things right in place. Make sure that the base mold is dried for at least half an hour before adding the secondary mold. It's going to be a little wobbly, it's okay, we'll get a hold of it easily. Always lay it on top of a baking paper or plastic so that it's easy for us to remove. If you're gonna place it in bare tiles, there are high chances for the clay to get stuck onto the bare tiles and our model will definitely go off. And since it's a bear, I'm starting to add details or creases with any sharp tool that we have. So I'm using a cutter. We can also use toothpicks or nails or screws, or we can also use fruit forks or anything that's there in our art piece, or you know, that's there in our hardware. So this is how it looks, and I'm pretty much satisfied with this look, but you gotta give more details But we gotta check for more details over here and start adding details and fixing the mold right in place. And again, let it dry for almost half an hour. Or until we find it, you know, just shake it. And if the mold doesn't fall off, it doesn't shake off and it's sturdy, we are done. So the drying time is done. Now it's time for us to paint. Choose the color accordingly. I kind of like this pearl emerald shade really well. It gives a nice tint and it's nice and vibrant. It's bright. It is a happy mood color. So one tip about it is I'm using acrylic colors over here. Acrylic colors are really good for all the clay projects. They hold on the color really well. If we are going to use a mold or the clay of any other color, say black or gray, or even if you're going to use polymer clay, it's going to be fine. But if you're not going to use polymer clay and if you're going to use raw clay, use white as a base color to enhance the features of our 3D structure. White definitely helps in enhancing or giving the effect of light and shade really well. So if I'm going to add the other layers right on top of it, so the first layer would be done and the second layer would be a color that's lighter in shade and the third layer would be the color that's darker in shade. This is the concept that we follow in watercolors. We go from light to dark, but rather in canvas paintings or acrylic paintings, we go from dark to light. We give the darker colors first and then we give the highlights. But in watercolors, we give the lighter colors first and then we go for the darker and shadows. So that's how the difference between the acrylic and watercolor in base works. So since this is a 3D structure and I wanted more of the beige, and then I'm just experimenting with this brown and beige color, and I just ended up giving brown completely. But this is how it works. You kind of get a 3D effect when you have the proper texture and when you have the proper color right inside the creases. So that's very important. And always give a tone of darker shade wherever we have bends, especially below our neck, right inside our earlobes, right between the arms, like right inside. Especially we are going to have a nice shadow inside our bare front body. So we can probably add a very thick layer of brown there as well. Always a combination of 2 to 3 different colors will highlight your art piece rather than going for a single color. Even if you're going for a single color, make sure to add a highlight or a darker tone to it. You can either play with a dark and lighter tone, or you can either play with highlights and shadows, like adding white or black to it. That'll again give a nice effect to your painting. In order to give a very sturdy base, I'm using wall putty. So even if I'm going to use candle inside, it will not affect the plastic that's there. A good thick layer of wall putty is definitely going to give me the nice sturdy base, at the same time a nice white color. The white color won't be dirty very quickly. At the same time, it's going to give that very nice bright effect and it'll complement the color that's outside. So no matter what we do, we are supposed to give a complete look, a complete finish to the painting by giving a nice contrasting shade. So this is where the highlight comes. So even if I'm going to place something inside this, since I have had a white color inside, it's gonna highlight up and show. Hope you guys like this. Meet you guys in the next video. Until then, namaste.